Hi, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net. And part of the fun, maybe half of the fun of having a garden is seeing how it turns out over a period of time. Last year, about this time, we were chopping down our major huge trees. We chopped down over 15 of them. And we replaced them with 17 other trees. And some of those were flowering trees. And some of them, like this peach, are fruiting trees, which is very exciting. Even though we're 2 months ahead of our time as far as the weather goes, it's just so exciting to see them blossoming out now and thinking each of these little blossoms could be a peach. That's very exciting. We may be canning peaches from our own tree this year.
Well, the other problem with trees is when you only have one species, such as our ash trees, and that they were dying and actually dead. Some of them were dead. I mean, it's sickening to have to cut down these huge, beautiful trees. But what do you do when they're dead? I mean, exactly. You know.
And so you plant new trees, but obviously they aren't going to be the same because it takes years and decades for them to get big. But it's beautiful and fun watching them develop, and you can appreciate each stage of their life. So we are enjoying highly all the trees that we can see. Come and see some of the other flowering ones. This is our little flowering crabapple tree. I love the red bark and the brilliant burgundy leaves that are coming. It will have pink blossoms on it when it actually blossoms shortly. Behind me is a Cleveland pear, flowering pear. Not an actual edible pear, but a flowering pear. And then beyond are going to be my flowering cherry trees. Come see those. As we were looking at the forsythia behind me and the three little river birches that we put in last year, we suddenly noticed that our bleeding heart not only is up, but look at this. It's all ready to blossom. That's amazing. This is a white one too. Somehow the white one got mixed in with the red one. These were tiny, teeny little transplants from the front of our house that we put in last year after blooming time. And here they are, happy as can be, already blooming. That is just amazing. These are dwarf lilacs. Yes, dwarf lilac bushes that are going to be absolutely gorgeous. And then here's another white bleeding heart.
These weren't up a couple of days ago at all.
No, they were not. They were not here. As our grandson would say, beating hearts. He thinks they're called beating hearts. Do we know what this is? No, we do not.
That's one of our river...
Is it?
River birch. Yep, because we had three of them. One there, there, okay. And there. So they were okay. Surrounding the forsythia.
Yes. And these are grandson named after himself. He took each of his names and gave one of them to each tree. So Logan, Marcus, and Rico are the names of these river birch. Keep growing. This is a flowering cherry. Again, it's not a cherry-producing tree. It's a flowering cherry. And this is the beautiful time of year for it. Coming along very nicely. They were wrapped and protected for the winter, so nobody was nibbling on them. And they made it through. And then my weeping tree. As a child, there was one house on the way to my girlfriend's house that was a weeping mulberry tree, and it always fascinated me. And then last year, my husband bought me a weeping cherry tree, which is even better because it blossoms. And it has gorgeous pink blossoms on. They are just This is the first day they actually open part way. So they're not even in full bloom yet. Let's see. Not really much of a smell to them yet, but maybe when the sun comes out there would be. It's just gorgeous. And our curly snake willow. It's gone from its blah winter to its bright green, spring green. That, to me, that is spring. When you start seeing the willow trees change from orange to yellow to green, that's spring. And it's in full glory. So we're happy our trees have survived and we're enjoying watching them. I hope you do too. Bye for now.